Hi, you guys. So my husband called and the phone rang, so I just want to show you what I ended up doing with that flower. I turned it like into little crystals, so we're going to go ahead and do that over here, and I'll show you exactly how I did it. So I have my linseed oil, and I have the alizarin red, and I put a little bit of green to give me that little brownish golden color, okay? So I'm going to try to kind of do the same thing, so, but what I'm going to do is a little bit in here, so it might not turn out to be exact, but we never know. So just want to do the little circle. What I did is I did the little circle for the little jewel, I'm using a different brush right now. And then, one, two, so it's got six. So, one, two, I turned, the other one. Remember, they were like this. We can do that. You do it like this. It's okay. It's not so perfect. This one could have five. They don't have to be exact. I don't want them to be. So, this one's going to have five. So you see how it is? And then, what I did is, they could just be any color jewels. I want some green ones over here, so let's grab a green one. This one could be different colors. So here's a green one. I put too much water here. Okay. So it's just a circle. There we go. And this one, let's say I want a red one. Or like a purple one. Let's go with purple. Here in the middle, okay. I want it to be a little bit bigger. There we go. There's that one. Then I want just a blue one, a regular blue one. This one's a blue one. But I'll let you know how the blue works. The bottom's going to be purple. Okay. Let's come over here with that green one. Okay. Then let's say I want just a light blue one. Let's do that, a light blue one. Okay. But I'm gonna put a little bit of dark blue on there with a little bit of purple to give me the roundness. And let me lift a little bit of the paint on there. So at this point, all I'm doing, I'm just doing circles. That's all I'm doing, just a circle. There we go. But I do want that blue one to have a little bit of purple on the bottom. Speaking of purple, I want a light purple one. So let's grab this and let's make a light purple one. amethyst. And then I'll get some of that dark purple too. See? And then the center is going to be yellow. So I'm just going to grab a little bit again of the alizarin crimson with some of that green, and then it's going to be yellow. And I'm going to add a little bit more blue and red to that yellow, because we have some blue reflecting off it. Then some of that green. Go some of that green. There we go. Hopefully you can see it. And then now just going in a circle around. I'm just doing an outer line. Okay, so on this one, some of the line kind of got mixed with a yellow gold. So I'm just going to grab a little bit of that gold. Just pop it back. I'm just grabbing some of that gold and popping it back. Then I could add more gold if I want, and then add that little highlight. This little line. Like that. And then we can go ahead and continue with the little line we had. So hopefully you can see what I did. And then you could add another swirl if you want to. Maybe one. We could do another one like this, or we can do one like this. So your little swirls could be any color you want. And then you could add a little bit of a red if you want to this. And then just highlight a little bit, or not highlight, but emphasize some of the shadow or color underneath, like it would. You would actually see something like this if you have that. Then we could add a little bit more of the little, I'm kind of wondering if I should do the little marks. This could actually be a continuation of this. I kind of wanted to make it that way. Let's see how it would look if I did. See? Then we could do another one over here, just like a little S. I just feel like doing the little S. Sometimes you'll see like little patterns forming there. Just go along with them. You know how it's kind of like dabbing the paint? Go ahead and do that. Whatever patterns you see form, that's a good thing. Here, I see the same thing. Right there. Then, let's see. Just trying to figure out how I can, because I didn't want both of them to swirl that way. And that would be too much swirling. You know what I mean? Like, they would be swirling too much to the same direction. Okay, add a little bit of red in there. Put some underneath to give it the illusion of a three-dimensional. Like if it comes down. I did see that this does come up a little bit. I'm just gonna do like a little, it's just not like the, it's just gonna stop there and Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a little bit of white. I've got to be careful because I have a lot of blue in there and white. And I don't want to stain it blue. So I have the white. So that white, okay, you guys, I had forgotten to hit record. What I did is I'm doing the feathers of a peacock, this half of it. I can't believe I forgot to hit play. So this is inspired by Art Nouveau jewelry. And I do want to extend this one. Okay, then I'm going to add some of this gold over here. Oh, let me make sure that it's close enough. Yeah, it's close enough. It's like a darker gold. I guess one of them's called, I was looking online to see what they're called. Some of them are called Aztec gold, bronze. I guess there's different names. I used to have peacock feathers. I had a teacher who had given me some one time, and guess what? Oh, I threw them away because I think my cat started destroying them. And then I said one day, well, let me just go to Hobby Lobby and buy some. I didn't know how expensive they were. She actually had real peacocks, and they had, I guess, their feathers. Like molted or mulched, whatever it's called. I'll take some of that off. I'll just take some off. I'll cut this before it gets in there. Work that a little bit, take it off. There we go. Now we can go. Okay. Okay, I was about to start singing. I have to catch myself. Sometimes I just want to break into song. My little doggy. Then you could add some of that green if you want. My dog's always bathing. You could add some of that green back here, maybe. Just the ones that were in the back. Two different colors. Doesn't matter to me that. Have any gold. So I got some gold. So I know that I'm using Sargent. The ones that I'm using are the Sargent tempera paint, the metallic ones. And let me see. How big are these? It doesn't tell me. 4 ounces. I was looking at them. I can list them on Amazon if you'd like. You don't have a Hobby Lobby or Michael's. When you see it and you do use the paint, I just look, it's really shiny, it's very glossy. Camera doesn't even pick up what it does, and it's just beautiful. The colors, and I wish you could see the beautiful colors. I'm going to put a little bit of white there. Okay. Then I'm going to add some silver. Down here. Go up a little bit. Okay. I'm always looking to And of course, you know that when I'm done with this, I'll have to add some of those shadows. Let's come over here right away. Let's go over here. To take this off because I think I don't want them being identical. So I'm going to grab a little bit of white, just cover some of it. I didn't want it to be identical. So the paint that I would mix is red and green, being alizarin crimson and sap green. Red and green. so I could give me like a brownish color. That way it doesn't. There we go. Okay. That still needs to dry. It's picking up some of that paint. So let's see, hopefully up here it's dry. Hopefully, right? Let's go over here. Let me roll this. Just trying to put the like this stops here. I'm trying to outline them, but I don't know if I'm going to outline all of them. I'm still kind of wondering about that. A little bit more leather and crimson, more green. Just take your time. Actually, this one comes Don't believe so at all. I saw that it connected. And this one. I'm going to have this one come this way. You can even have it come all the way up here. I'm actually going to highlight. There we go. Not highlight, but trace it. It doesn't matter to me that some of them come in a little bit darker. I don't have a problem with it. I like the way it's looking. Just go up here where I'm at. I am taking my time with this. Know that. Not rushing at all.